Today we will discuss parallel plate capacitor filled with a dielectric. We consider a parallel plate capacitor with plate area A and distance D between the plates. Now we insert a dielectric slab of dielectric constant K in the space between the plates. As you see in the figure, dielectric between the plate of the parallel plate capacitor. The charge on one side of the plate is plus Q and the charge on the other side of the plate is minus Q. The slab almost fills the entire space between the plates. Now we give a charge plus Q to one plate and minus Q charge to the other plate of the capacitor. Suppose the induced charges due to the polarization of the dielectrics are plus QP and minus QP. Here P stands for polarization on the two faces of the slab close to the plates as seen in figure. The surface charge density on the plates is Q upon A. Then the electric field between the plates due to the charges plus Q and minus Q on the capacitor plates is given by E naught is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught is equal to substituting value of sigma Q upon A epsilon naught. This is the equation number 1. Now according to the definition of the dielectric constant, the resultant field inside the slab is given by E is equal to E naught upon K. In substituting the value of E naught from equation number 1, we get E is equal to Q upon epsilon naught AK. Hence the corresponding potential difference between the plates is given by V is equal to ED. Here again using the value of E from equation number 2, we obtain V is equal to Q upon epsilon naught AK into D, or Q is equal to epsilon naught AK V upon D. This is the equation number 4. Now let C be the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor with the dielectric in between its plates. Then Q is equal to CV. Comparing equation number 4 and 5, we get C is equal to epsilon naught AK upon D, and we can write it as K C naught, where C naught is equal to epsilon naught A upon D is the capacitance without the dielectric. So we see that capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor is increased by K times when the space between the plates is filled with a dielectric of dielectric constant K. Also from equation number 6, the definition of dielectric constant can be given as K is equal to C upon C naught is equal to capacitance of parallel plate capacitor filled with dielectric divided by capacitance of the capacitor without dielectric. Now if the dielectric is removed from the space between the capacitor plates, the potential difference V naught will increase because the fixed volume of charge Q. So Q is equal to CV and Q is equal to C naught V naught, or C naught V naught is equal to CV. From this equation we get V naught is equal to C upon C naught into V, or V naught is equal to KV, or V naught is greater than V since K is greater than 1. Now we have to calculate magnitude of induced charge. The electric field at a point between the plates due to plus Q and minus Q charges on the plates is E naught is equal to Q upon A epsilon naught. The electric field EP due to charge QP and minus QP charges is directed opposite to E naught and has the magnitude given by EP is equal to nu P upon epsilon naught is equal to QP upon A epsilon naught. Resultant field E is equal to E naught minus EP is equal to Q minus QP upon A epsilon naught. From equation number 2 and 9 we get Q upon epsilon naught AK is equal to Q minus QP upon A epsilon naught, or Q upon K is equal to Q minus QP, or QP is equal to Q 1 minus 1 upon K. So the induced surface charge QP is always less than the free charge Q and is 0 when K is equal to 1, or dielectric is not present in the parallel plate कैपेसिटर मीडियम। थैंक यू।